All hail the beard, it's your boy Big Beard B, and we back for another edition of Big Beard Business. For those of you who are new to the channel, I'm B, and on this channel, we help you improve your confidence by way of compliments using the wonderful world of fragrance. If this is your second video or more, we ask that you hit the subscribe button so you can come back to rock with your boy. Today, we're talking about a 2021 release from the house of Dolce & Gabbana, and the fragrance is none other than Light Blue Forever. Now listen, this is, as I mentioned, a 2021 release, and it's a fragrance that I was not going to review, but a lot of you hit me up and say, yo, B, we're waiting for this review, so I decided I would give it to you. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have left you without this review to step to. So as always, we'll go ahead and kick it off with the presentation, and here we have it. Now I'll tell you, this box is cool. It has this velvety feel, kind of gives me this Intensio, I believe that was the name of that fragrance. It came like the purple box. Give me that type of vibe. But enough about that. Let's go ahead and get down to this juice here. Now the presentation, it looks very similar to what a lot of the Light Blue fragrances would look like, right? Small differences, but we don't really care about that. What we care about is the juice here, what this thing smells like. Now this may go without saying, but we are talking about the pour-on version here. There is a parfum out there, which the bottle is very different than what you would see here. So if you're looking for it, this is what we're talking about. Now in terms of what this thing smells like, we'll go ahead and start with the note breakdown. In the top of this fragrance, you're gonna have some grapefruit, and then you also have bergamot. As you move over into the mid, you get some ozonic notes, and then you also get some florals. And then in the base of this fragrance, it's said to have vetiver, as well as patchouli and some musk. Now, here is your distribution. That's what the spray looks like on this thing. And here's the deal. Now, as I mentioned, I wasn't going to review this fragrance initially. I try to center a lot of my reviews on things that I'm really, really enjoying, etc. Here, this fragrance really starts off a bit different for me, and it's probably going to be the unpopular opinion here, but it is what it is. On the start of this fragrance, or the top of this fragrance, on that first spray, I don't enjoy it, all right? So I know a lot of you out there are like, yo, I love the top of this fragrance, I enjoy it. Eh, me, not so much here. This grapefruit in this fragrance really comes off as what a grapefruit should come off as, and I don't like eating grapefruit, and not that I'm not a fan of grapefruit and fragrances, but this one here is very prominent and pronounced, right? So the grapefruit here is very loud and in your face in the top here, and it's not something that I truly enjoy. The grapefruit here comes off as tart, a little bit sour, if you'll call it that, and you know, it's just not something that I'm running to spray on me all the time. But what I'll tell you is that as it goes away, right, and that the bergamot is there, helps add a little freshness, but all in, if you're going to spray this fragrance, you're going to smell that grapefruit for sure. All right, so as this fragrance transitions into that mid of this fragrance, it has some ozonic notes, right, also some florals, very slightly that you get that, and then it gets down into the dry down here, and that's really where I begin to enjoy this fragrance versus the top notes here. And you may enjoy the top notes, and it is what it is, right? But for me, it's not so much. As this fragrance begins to dry down is where it becomes a fragrance that I really do enjoy, but I find it difficult to get past that opening for me a lot of the time. So here's the deal. When it gets down to that dry down, as I mentioned, you get some vetiver, you got some patchouli, and you also get some musk there. But that musk and the vetiver really are the key players there for me as it goes in that dry down, right? And it also comes off slightly creamy there as well, which is something that I enjoy. So it has like a bunch of stages here, with still being a simplistic fragrance, but different as well. And I'll say different because if you're looking at a lot of the stuff that has been released on the market 2021 in terms of designer fragrances, this one takes a completely different route. There are a lot of sweet fragrances out there, a lot of fresh fragrances, and you get that here. You get a little bit of sweetness, you get some freshness, but again, you get that almost photorealistic grapefruit in this fragrance that really stands out, and it should be called Light Blue Grapefruit. that's my personal thoughts and opinions there. All in, man, I think that this fragrance would be enjoyed by most, but then you're gonna have some like me who were like, nah, I'm not really feeling that grapefruit. But again, in that dry down where that musk and the vetiver really come into to life there, I think the fragrance becomes more enjoyable for sure. Now, I am a fan of vetiver in fragrances, and this vetiver comes off in a way that I personally enjoy. It's clean, not too green, not too smoky, just clean. And I think with that grapefruit there, that freshness that you get from that grapefruit and the bergamot there, that overly fresh vibe that you still carry on into that mid of the fragrance, and then having some clean feel in that base of the fragrance, really, really is something that I enjoy, just that mid and then the base there. So top notes here for me, not so much. But the good thing about it is that I don't get it for a very long time, all right? It's really about 30 minutes to 45 minutes in terms of that top note, that grapefruit really being prominent there for me. Although you still get hints of it throughout the rest of the fragrance and into that mid before it gets into the dry down. But for me, I find that part something that is tolerable, okay? So I can tolerate that versus just that opening of that grapefruit. All in, I think that, again, there are going to be people who enjoy this fragrance, others who do not. Is this a safe blind buy? It could be. It could be. But I would say for those who are into fragrances, right? If you understand what you're getting in terms of a fresh fragrance, specifically with the note of grapefruit here. And I'm only bringing this up because I think that the grapefruit here is really an authentic grapefruit feel. And if you're not into that, then you probably won't be into this, all right? You'll probably opt for something of different in terms of blue fragrances like a Bleu de Chanel or something like that, or maybe even one of the other flankers or the original for that matter. In terms of performance for like Blue Forever, I would say the fragrance performance is good, especially for that heavy citrus that you get in the top here. Again, that bergamot and that grapefruit kind of combination goes away from that pronounced feel after about 30 to 45 minutes, but you get a nice projection on this fragrance for about an hour and a half to 2 hours for about, 2 feet or so, and then it kind of settles down to a little bit more moderate feel. All in, I would say 5 to 7 hours in terms of longevity, but again, with that something that is super fresh like this, you know, that's going to be average, right? And the compliment factor for this, I would say, is moderate, all right? And again, not bad at all. Could be better, it could be worse. So it's really moderate there. All in, I think this is a fragrance that a lot of people will enjoy. Obviously, you guys have been asking for it, right? And I have backed off of it because it's not my favorite fragrance out there, again, but it is what it is in terms of me. Let me know how you feel about this fragrance. If this is fragrances like, hey, a must have for you, I would love to know. In terms of when to wear this fragrance, spring, summer for sure. That's definitely where you want to rock this fragrance, or where you're going to get the best performance out of this fragrance, or at least the best feel out of this fragrance. In terms of like what you would wear when you're rocking this fragrance, I would say this fragrance is more in that casual feel. With that heavy citrus, you would probably lean more toward casual feel. But however, if you have 30 to 45 minutes before you're getting to a formal event, maybe not formal, right? But if you're going like to the office or something, 30, 45 minute drive before that citrus dries down a bit, I think that you would probably fare well to wear it in a office setting. Generally speaking, I would say that it's an inoffensive fragrance, you know, crowd pleasing, yeah. So you probably won't have, you know, any complaints with it in the office. So you could probably wear it with confidence and really proceed with caution in terms of the amount of sprays, and you'll be a-okay there. So that's my take on this fragrance, Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue Forever. Which fragrance within their flanker series works best for you? I would love to know. As always, I'm your boy, Big B. Hit the like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend that we are back again. And you already know what I need you to do. Just hit the goddamn bell.